enterprise face the wrath of members of parliament over its dubious deals with a Gupta-linked company. Denel struggled today to explain why it entered into an almost half a billion rand deal with VR laser company while it was reported to be under financial difficulties. Its chairperson and members of the executive appeared before parliament's portfolio committee on public enterprises.
Denel refuted reports that VR Laser was going through financial strains at the time it entered into a 400 million rand deal. The arms manufacturing entity says the deal was struck in 2013 before the current board and executives took over. But surprisingly, it confirmed that it was at the same time the Guptas bought a stake in the company.
Gupta family bought and interest into that business, which Denel has absolutely no control over. Anybody is obviously entitled to do as they please if they want to invest in the space. Around 2013, around about that time, I'm now speaking under correction, 2013-2014, the WHO-FESTA contract, as it relates to the portion that VR Laser is to do, was contracted.
There was no satisfactory answer why Denel hired VR Laser to do in Asia what it could have done. Then a barrage of questions about state capture from legislators followed.
Chair, I think that the perception of capture is going to remain in the public domain. We need to be convinced, how is it that out of all the many entities that might be involved, an entity that belongs to a particular set of families is always the ones that we go to and have to do business with.
I'd put it to Denel to say that with the evidence in front of me and with the evidence in front of all other South Africans, you are very much captured.
My fear from experience is that another state-owned enterprise gave an advance to a Gupta-owned company to buy a mine. Now here we worried as well that Denel could give an advance to VR Laser Asia to take them out of this technically insolvent position.
Denel denied it was captured.
Most of the perceptions are as a result of the fake news that is feeding our country. I think for members, we take the responsibility to say whatever the issues relating, whether we are captured or not captured, which obviously the answer is a no, no, no.
The Treasury will be next in the firing line to explain these and other deals between SOEs and the Gupta-linked companies. Manilisi Tubase, SABC News, Parliament.